back at it again. Today I'm going to be bringing you guys a $250 dime box hunt. I went to my bank and I got a box of dimes. I'm very excited for this one. I have a lot of holes to fill out in my collection and I'm definitely looking for some silver. So without further ado, let's break into this thing and see if we got any enders, guys. So I've just opened up my first roll of dimes here. You know, I haven't done dimes in about a month or so. It's really tricky looking at these small dates on these things. So I'm not really going to be able to open these all up on camera for you guys because I got to be able to check all these newer dates. There's so many different variations I'm looking for these. A lot of the newer dates actually are, especially the 2000P is very rare. If I can find a very fine version of that, it's worth almost $20, I would say, or maybe about 10 bucks. But so I'm going to keep my eyes peeled for 2000P and anything 1970 and earlier. So I'm going to keep opening these rolls and anything good I find, I'll let you guys see what I find. So let's keep this going. All right, about six rolls down. I haven't found anything too cool yet, but I just found this. Someone obviously got really mad at this dime and just took out their anger on it. So yeah, don't scratch up your change with razor blades, people. Like, whoa, easy. But yeah, I just wanted to show you guys that. Crazy. But on with the hunt. Hope we find some silver. Well, so far on my quest for silver, I'm still getting skunked. I'm about a third of the way through the box. Not quite, but almost there. But I did just find some foreign currency. That's pretty cool. This 10 cents from Barbados. So that's kind of interesting. So I'll add that to my pile. Keep looking and let's pray for some silver because I'm starting to get a little worried now. Let's hope we find something because I don't know. Most of these are all just duplicates of ones I already have. I don't know. I haven't found anything newer than 1969 so far. 1969 is a good date because there is one that was minted in Philadelphia and one that was minted in Ottawa. So maybe at the end of this video I'll try and show you guys which version of that I found. But let's keep looking and hope for some silver. Just found something kind of interesting. Looks like someone might have sanded this one or something like that, or machine milled it. But I kind of like the looks of it, so I might actually hold on to this one because it looks kind of cool. I don't know what year it is, 2000 something. Definitely not anything special about the actual mintage or anything, but it just looks kind of cool to me, so yeah, not bad. Well, unfortunately, I did not get any of the silver I was hoping for, but you know, that's sometimes the way she goes. But I did get a few 1968s, and that's the thing with Canadian dime hunts, is there's always a small chance that one of your 1968 dimes could be 50% silver. So I'm going to have to throw those on the scale and test their magnetics and then see where they're at. I also found this Bahamas coin, which is pretty cool. Found the really interesting dime right there. And I only found about 5 US dimes during this hunt, which is the least amount of US coins I've come across during a coin hunt so far. Usually I find a lot more than that. In the last nickel hunt I did, I found about a 30% US to Canadian coin ratio. So this was the least amount of American coins I've ever gotten in a hunt. These are all 2007s that I found. So what I'm going to do for you guys is I'm going to throw on the microscope and I'm going to look for two good specimens, one of each of the curved variation and the straight variation. So I'll show you guys right here very quickly. As you can see, for the one 2007 there, it's the straight 7, and then we have another one here that's the curved 7. So either way, in mint, they're worth about $3, it looks like, for the straight or the non-straight. So let's take a quick look, and hopefully we got a few straight ones, which I'm pretty sure we do. So just to give you guys an idea of what we're looking at here, as you can see, this one is the straight 7. And let's see if I can find one with a curved 7, a good example. Well, after looking through about 20 coins, I have to say there wasn't a single curve variation. They're all the straight 7s, which is a shame because I would have liked to get both of the variations in my book. But I did during this hunt get to fill out my book very nicely, so that was pretty awesome. But I was really hoping to get some silver. This was my second ever box dime hunt, so it's not that big of a deal that I didn't get any silver today because I'm gonna definitely try again. But yeah, thanks a lot for following along, guys. Hopefully next time I can bring you something a little bit more interesting. I'm most likely gonna be doing a nickel hunt next, so stay tuned for my channel for that, and happy hunting, guys. How's it going, everybody? Dr. Coin back at it again, and welcome back to the Coin Cave. Well, it's another nickel night here. I got another box, and I gotta say, I took a look inside, and it's not looking as promising as the last box in my last video. When I went through that one, I saw a lot of good enders, and I didn't see nothing too crazy in this one, but what I will do, I took a look inside, and this whole box is paper rolls, so this is going to be one of the first boxes that I look through that are entirely paper rolls. So that is definitely going to be interesting. But without further ado, what do you say we bust into this thing and see what's inside? So, gonna do the first five rolls for you guys. If you guys have been following me along so far, you'll know that I found a 1944 silver US war nickel in my last box, so that was awesome. So, let's hope we can get something similar in this box. I mean, a King George Canadian would be nice. 2015 right there. So, I'll show you guys the enders as I go along. If you guys enjoy my videos, or you guys enjoy Canadian coin roll hunting, or Canadian coin collecting, or coin collecting in general, please subscribe to my channel, give a thumbs up. I would greatly appreciate that. But without further ado, let's start looking through this thing and see what we got. Well, we got a 1980 right there, so that's good. A 95. Washed out. So this has been going completely awesome so far. I've the amount of support I've received, the amount of knowledge that I've been able to gain has just been amazing. So I'd like to thank you everybody so much for all the support and all the knowledge that you have been dropping on me. You know, they say knowledge is power, and one of the most important things I can recommend to new collectors, as well as I did for myself, is get yourself a coin book, because the knowledge is absolutely key. If you don't know what to look for, then you're basically wasting your time. So, all right. So, not seeing anything too crazy in this box, or sorry, in this roll. Nope, nothing there. Well, that's a bummer. But not too big of a deal. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take out four rolls here, and then I'm gonna dump these into the box. Another great use for my coin roll mats. These are my new design for my coin roll mats. If you guys haven't seen them yet, this is pretty much gonna be the final design, I think. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make them a lot bigger, a lot more higher quality, most likely some on a mouse pad quality material, and I'm probably gonna have some other really cool ones too. So if you guys are interested in these or some of my other coin mats, then check out my eBay page in the description. But let's see what we got. And roll number two. Hopefully we have a little more luck because nothing in roll one. I'm really hoping I can get a George in this box, but you never know. We might not get anything at all. So let's see. What are we gonna find? Maybe a 2000p. That's always nice. That would make it almost worth it, but not quite. It's really the old stuff that you're always looking for. I mean, I'm really hoping I can find a World War II nickel in one box. That would really make me a happy camper. I still have nothing that resembles an actual World War II quarter, or sorry, nickel, just a whole heck of a lot of the commemoratives. So, roll number two, skunked. Completely skunked so far. This is kind of what I was expecting. This box looks very new. Along with all of these rolls, they all looked customer wrapped. I mean, not a great sign. No markings on them. I mean, I usually, back in the days when I would wrap them all in these rolls, I would mark X's to let myself know that I looked through them. So I don't think these are recycled boxes from other banks that I'm getting from myself. Because you definitely don't want to do that. Get your old boxes, whether it be from your own bank that you turn them into, which I don't recommend you doing, or your bank turns them into your other bank somehow. I don't know if it works like that, but 74, that's one of the older ones so far, which is not good. 2001, we got 2000 here. 2000, plain. Bummer. All right, quick scroll through the rest of this. And a whole lot of that new. Bummer. Ah, man, this box. But you can't strike gold in everyone, you know? You can't strike silver. Especially with nickel boxes. I mean, I never expected to find a war nickel in a Canadian box. So that was a lovely treat. Not seeing anything here on first sight. Let's see if I can get a better angle for you guys here. So, usually, easiest way to tell is you just look at the head. Because we aren't looking for anything earlier. Or sorry, anything with the uncrowned. So, you can just quickly skim through all those pretty quick. A 1965. Well, hey, there's something. We can keep that and look for the large beads. So, hey, at least we got something. 2001p. Close, but no. What do we got here? It's not an octagon, but we got something. This is good. A 64. Should have known. These are common. But we will gladly take anything before 65. Quickly look through the rest. Maybe we'll get lucky here. 84. A couple diadems in here. 68. Used to keep those, but getting pretty stringent with my what I like to keep now. So there's roll number 4. At least we got something. I mean, wasn't looking too good with those first couple rolls, but we'd like to see something pre-60. A Canadian pre-60. A Canadian pre-50. A 2001P. What do you know? 94. We got our first US of the box right here. What is it going to be, guys? It's going to be 2015P. We'll see if we need it for our U.S. nickel collection. Oh, man. That almost got me there. Because it almost looked washed out in the roll, but close, but no cigar. Quick scan through. You find a lot of these. So, no point in holding on to those, but they are nice. If that's your thing. You got a 76. Alright guys, well that's going to do it for the first 5 rolls live. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tune you out now, tune you guys back in if and when I find anything else good, which hopefully I do. So, tune you guys back in.
A few moments later.
Alright, so I'm bringing you guys back in. I haven't found anything too crazy yet, but some good news to report. I have found my first 2000p of the box. So that is a good find, and it's in good condition too. So that's a nice one. And then I also found my second young head, I think, of the box. Yes, second young head. So I have two 1964s now. So what I'm going to do quickly is I am going to check for The water line on the 64s. Nope, no water line on that one. And no water line on that one either. So when you're looking for the water line, you're looking for the water to be touching the KG initials on the water ripples there coming off of the log. So, and then I'm also quickly going to check the 1965 I found. That is definitely a small beads. So, not what we're looking for there. And then we are going to check 77. We got a low 7. So, all right. But basically just wanted to tune you guys in and let you know about the 2000 that I found, because the 2000 is definitely a good one to keep your eye out for. So, what I'm going to do, I'm about halfway through now, so I'll keep going, and I'll let you guys know if and when, hopefully, I find something else. Alright, so I have concluded the hunt, and unfortunately, I did not get any octagons, and I did not get anything pre-1963, which is a huge bummer, but honestly, when you get a 2000, it kind of makes up for it, because 2000 is a very low mintage. It's around 5 million, actually under 5 million minted, so we will gladly take it. And what I'll do quickly too is I'm going to show you guys how to differentiate between a 2000P and not P. It's pretty simple. This one you can see has the P there, pretty pronounced P. And then I saved this one just to show you guys. This one, no P. So, big difference between these two right here. Believe it or not. This is the keeper. So, show you guys what else I got here. What I have right here is a lonely little 1965, which we already checked for the large beads. And then right here we have the 1977s, then two 1963s. So, no variations on these, unfortunately, but they are still in good shape. So, we will keep the 63s and put them with our other 63s. 64s, we got 1996s. And the reason we keep 1996s, if you guys aren't aware, is there is two varieties for 1996. There is a close 6 and a far 6, or near 6 or far 6, they call it. And I believe it was also featured on the 1926. So they included it on the 1996 as well. So that's a cool one to look out for. And what I'll do is I'll throw some of these under the microscope, actually. And we can see if we have any near and far sixes, or if we can even tell the difference, because it can be a little tricky. So you can see that one looks like a near six to me, because the six is near to the D. So we'll quickly just check the others and see if they all look similar, or if they are, yep, that one's close to the D. And close to the D as well. So, I'm expecting that if you have a far 6 variety, the 6 is going to be a lot farther down towards the denticles. So that's what you want to watch out for with the far 6 variations of nickels. I'm pretty sure it goes the same way for the 1926 variety. If I get my hand on a couple of those, I'll show you. So these right here are the US nickels. And what I will do is I will go through my book quickly, see if any of these will fill them out, and if not, I'm sorry, I won't be able to show you that clip, but hopefully I'll be able to fill my book in with a couple of these. And this is the toner of the box right here, so kind of an interesting color on this. It's like a rusty color, but I really hope somebody didn't die with this in their pocket or something, but kind of interesting, you know, a little toner of the box, so not bad. Alright, so what I'll do is I will see if my US nickel book needs any of its spots filled out, and then I will tune you guys back in. Well, that really shows you how far my collection is coming along because out of all of those, not a single one could go in the book. So they're all going back into the box and back to the bank. And that's just the way it goes. I mean, I wish I could have gotten something a little bit older, but you really have to take these hunts for what you can. I mean, you have to learn some of the little rarities you can find. Like this, for example, is worth a couple bucks on its own. I've only found three of them, and this one might be in the best shape so far of all of them. So, doesn't want to zoom on it. So, this 2000p is not too bad. I consider it in around the same realm as what I would say a young head octagon. Not quite at a level of a George head, but still can kind of validate doing this hunt because sometimes, you know, when you search through a couple thousand coins, it can be hard to validate your time searching through it. But I really enjoyed it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you like, please like and subscribe. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe and hit the bell so you can be notified of my new videos. And I have some cool old videos on detecting old Canadian rarities and coins and stuff like that. So this is kind of the end of the dry streak or the hot streak, guys. I think this is kind of telling me that I need to switch it up. In the next video, I'm probably going to do a couple boxes of dimes or a quarter box in my next hunt video at least. And so yeah, that's pretty much going to do it for this one. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Happy hunting to everybody and peace out. So it's time to break into this bad boy and see what we're dealing with here. I got my handy dandy letter opener as usual. So they taped this sucker pretty good. Hopefully they taped it for a good reason here. All right. We have broken the seal. So now time to look and see if we got any enders. And I can see that they are pretty circulated, so that's good. A good sign right away. You always want to look and see if you got circulated coins, so. All right. Yep, it looks like. Looks like these are pretty circulated. Awesome, so. I'm not going to look at every single one of these for enders because there's no point because a lot of them are wrapped on the one side. So what I'm going to do is I am just going to start breaking into each one of these rolls for you guys and let's see what we got. So let's take a look. So let it begin. Roll number one. Let's see what we got. We got a plastic roll. So we're going to be able to look right off the bat and see what exactly we are dealing with here. Well, you can tell right off the bat that there isn't any octagon nickels there. At the Centennial. Doesn't want to zoom. There we go. But that's not really what I'm looking for right now. Looking for 2006s. That's a good year. 2006s without a mint mark. But I'm also gonna have to take a look and see what I need in my collection because there's a 2000 right there. Now, if this is a 2000 and P, that's good. Nope, that is not a 2000 P, that is just a regular 2000. Now, that is unfortunate. But I'll put it aside for now. Two thousand seven, 2003. 2003 P's can actually be pretty decent too. So, but I have a bunch of those already. I don't really need to hold on to those. A very nice looking 2001 P there. Very shiny. I don't think it's a proof, but I'm definitely going to put it to the side. Because that is nice. A little bit of lint there. That's always nice to get. 2006. What does it got? Royal Canadian Mint mark or nothing? Let's hope for nothing. I think that's a P or it's a nothing. But we're going to hold on to that. Oh, that's a 2005. But I'm not seeing a lot of old ones in this roll. But, you know, it's not even a paper roll, so what are you gonna do? Alright. So, let's clean this up and let's open the next roll. I was just taking a quick look at my collection to see exactly what I needed to fill in, and I am super stoked right now because I have the 2005 commemorative War Nickel, but I do not have the regular 2005, and I just got that, so that's awesome. So some of the other ones, quickly, just a quick run over that I'm looking for big time are the 1991, 1997. I'm also looking for 2009 and 2010. Those are going to be pretty easy to find. So let's keep this going, and let's see what we find in roll number two. So, roll number two. What are we going to get? A paper roll. Hopefully we get something a little bit older in this one. Come on, get out of there. Well, we definitely got full rolls, it looks like. Not bad. So we're starting to get some older years here. Let's see. Another Centennial 92. Getting to the oldies. Ooh, there we go. A 68. Now, might have to check that one out with the microscope after, because there is some sweet variations for this one. Throw that in the pile. Very nice, shiny 2018. Alright, time to pick up the pace. Gotta get where we're going. 1998, unfortunately, not a 1997. That'd be nice. Ooh, a 2000, but not a 2000P, but that's in good shape. So, throw that in the pile. 84, 2009, 1999. That's a 10P. You know, I don't keep all of the ones that I throw to the side, but sometimes if it just looks interesting, I'll throw it and make a second guess after whether I want to keep it or not. A lot of them, probably more than half, I end up chucking back or putting back into the rolls. So if you see me keeping a lot of them or see me putting a lot of them in the keep pile over here, doesn't necessarily mean I'm keeping them. So, nothing earlier than this Elizabeth head so far, but a pretty good sign. 2000, not a 2000P, looking for that 2000P always, that's the big one, Another 2005P, but not as in good a shape as the other one we got. Alright. Let's clean this up. Rule number three. Really hoping I can pull an octagon nickel out of one of these rolls really soon, just to give me a little bit of confidence. That's always when my heart starts pounding, is when I see those octagon sides. Ooh, there's a really dark one there at the end, but it just looks really nasty. Ooh, it's a nasty 2012. This one looks awfully shiny. What is this one? A 2016, very shiny 2016. But nothing too special about it as far as I can see. Take a quick gander through the rest of these here. But I do not see, look at this one. That's just disgusting. Someone threw this in a campfire or something. Nasty. Alright. A lot of new ones in this one. That's not good. That is not good at all. What is that? A 90? A 90. Alright, we'll hold on to that. We'll hold on to that. 95. Boy, these 91s can be tricky. Oop. What is this? 74. Nice. Okay, so there's a few old ones tucked away in this guy. Not a single US coin yet either. Strange. Usually I find a lot more US coins by now. I usually throw those to the side. You never know with those US coins when you're going to have a nice valuable one. Not a lot of 2006s in here either, huh? Strange. Alright, well, a few old ones. Alright, let's see what's in the next one. So I think the oldest that I found so far is a 68. See if we can find something a little older than that, please. I thought I might have saw something there, but might have just tricked my eyes. Not any octagons that I can see from there, but sometimes they can stay tucked away. Another 68. Nice. A 98, 90, 82. Whoops, don't think I wanted to keep that 2008. Nope, not at all. Gotta make sure you chuck them in the right pile. Strange. Not many 2000. Oh, there we go. 2006. What does it have on the back? Nothing. Sweet. That is the good one. Not in good shape, though. If this was a little in better shape, it might be worth a couple bucks, actually. Like a buck or two. But throw it in the pile. That 2006 with no mint mark. It's a nice one. Keep your eye out for it. 85. Not what we are looking for. Ooh. 2006P. Now that's the one you don't want. You want it to either have nothing or you want it to have the Royal Canadian Mint mark. So What's this old one look like? 1985. 1985. I'm going to be chucking a lot of these back. 1993. Now, I wish that was 1991. Wish it was 91, 2001. P. I already found that. Mm. 1998. I already found a bunch of those, so I'm not going to throw any more of those in the pile. Actually, you know what? I think 98 was a limited year. I'm still going to hold on to the 90s and judge that a little bit later. 2003. Well, there's the 92 Centennial. Well, skunked again on the next one.
This is the part where I start to get a little worried. Am I going to get anything in this box? A single octagon nickel. I don't know. But even one would make it worth my time, so. But that World War II nickel, oof, would I like to have that one.
To find it in the wild would be nice. Okay. Where do we get here? What do we get? No octagon sides, but do we have anything of age? Oh, there's a U.S. right there. First one I've seen. Doesn't want to focus. There we go. It's not the US though. Ooh. That's a five. Alright, now what year is this US? Are we gonna get an old one? Looks like a 2002P.
Nope, not an old one. But still.
Throw it in the pot. Ooh, icky. That does not look very nice. 2003 Centennial. Don't really want to touch this one. This is why I usually should probably wear gloves, but I just wash my hands pretty frequently whenever I do anything besides open these rolls. But that does not look nice. Ew. Put that side over there. I see that. Alright. Keep this going. Speed it up. 2014, 16. So, still a lot of new ones. Still no octagons. Only one American 1985. There we go. But not what we're looking for. Probably not going to keep most of those 85 or 80s. Probably going to toss most of them back. A 90 in decent shape. A 92 Jefferson. '91, '90. Boy, these 91s are hard to find, I tell you. 87, ooh, I like the look of that one. It's got some age and, you know, some character to it. Looks like very old, but interesting. All right. right. Nothing in that one. Nothing worth mentioning, at least. Really hoping this box will bear some fruit soon. Something earlier than a 68. Something from the 50s, maybe. Something with a young Elizabeth head. Now, I have found young George heads in these rolls, but it's not very often. Well, that's unfortunate. Nothing at first sight. Let's see. Ooh, another gross one there. Not nice. No, a 96, not a 97. Sorry, a little bit of an interruption there, but going through that roll, I did find a 2006 with the Royal Canadian Mint mark. So, there is the other variation of the three. So, not bad. On to the next. My success rate with these rolls has been not so good. I don't know about you guys, but maybe you can let me know how you guys do with these clear rolls if you ever get them. But, I mean, it's pretty easy to tell if there's old coins in there. So, if they're hand rolled, then most likely. Man, they just tape these things so friggin' well. How the heck are you supposed to get in there? That is quite the tape job. Well, screw that roll. Deal with that one later. Let's see. Here. Ooh, what's that? That's interesting. No, that's just an extremely dirty Centennial. Alright. Not what we are looking for. Let's see. 93. Even if I can find a 91, that would be very nice. Oh, our second American. Ooh. That was a nice sheen to it. Very nice. Interesting. 1990. All right. Very nice. Another dirty Centennial. I don't know why those want to attract so much dirt. They like to disguise themselves as the old ones, I guess. Well, another stinker. Alright, so I'm going to open this one last roll on camera for you guys, and then I'm going to just do updates for every couple rolls that I do if I find anything good, which is how I usually do it. But let's see if anything in this last roll. Well, no octagons from the first look. Well, you can tell this one went through a coin counter. From the lines going around the outside, you can see. Usually coin counting machines will make indentations like that on the coins. So, that's kind of interesting. But, not a year that we want, so. Is that an American? Nope. Oh, that's a very shiny Centennial. Interesting. Well, looks like nothing in that world too. Well, so far, not looking good. So, I'm going to jump ahead a few rolls and let you guys know if I find anything interesting. So, I'll tune you guys back in a few. So, I just found this roll. Don't know exactly what this means, but this could be something. Let's take a look. Oh my God, guys. Oh my God. Oh my God, guys. This entire roll. Oh my. No. No, this is not. This cannot be possible. I'm not even joking, you guys. I'm not. This is no. No, no, no. 1964. No way. No way. Oh my God. 1963. No way. Oh my God. These are all young Elizabeth heads. This is why we do this. Oh my God. Oh my God. 68. 63, 64, these are all exactly what the rolls said, 60 to 64, there might be something else in here, guys. Oh my, oh my, oh my, 68, no, 63, those threes really look like eights, jeez, probably looks better for you guys on the camera. Oh my, oh my, no way, 64, 64. I can't believe this. I can't believe this. How? 63. These are all. That is amazing. That is amazing. None of these are octagons, though, that I can see so far. I think I might see a few more ahead there, actually. Let's see. We can get a little bit earlier than these 63s. 63. Oh my. Well, I think this box was worth it. Oh, there we go. We just hit some octagons right there. This is what I'm talking about. Oh yeah. 63. What are these? What are these octagons here? 62. This must be a collection dump right here. 62. 62. These are in really good shape too. If there's any variables in here, then I'm gonna have a heyday looking for those. Well, I think I found some octagons. These are all sorted too, it looks like. The farther back you go, the older they seem to get. 61. This is amazing. This is amazing. I should have just kept this going because this was two rolls down from when I stopped. That is ridiculous. That is ridiculous. I still have a lot of rolls left to go. 60. So, this is exactly what the rolls say, 1960 and up. There could be something else special in here. But even if there isn't, this is it.
This is worth it. That's a whole roll of 1960 to 1964 nickels. Now, my writing ain't even that pretty, so I can't believe that. I don't even have words, but that is amazing. So, I might take a look and see if there's any more rolls that have that written on it. But if not, then I'm going to keep going through it, and I'm going to let you guys know if I find anything else. Well, I guess today's my lucky day, because I just found these. Well, at least I hope it's my lucky day. I mean, they could have been some older dates, but if these are what they say they are, then I don't know. 1964, a whole roll of 1964s. That's interesting. I wonder why the bank didn't mess with this. They just probably counted all the rolls and gave this guy his money. Whoops. Well, it looks like this is exactly what it says it is, which is a whole roll of 1964s. So, this is probably worth a couple more than $2, probably like $3 or $4 for this. So, that's not bad. Hold on to this. All right. I'm just gonna roll this back up right into these rolls after, honestly. Why not? To whoever left these at the bank, thank you very much. Very much appreciated. If you don't want them, I'll gladly take them. So 1964 and 65. This is with keeping with the other two rolls, then I'm expecting a roll of 64s and 65s. Well, looks like a 65. No. I believe it's 65s with the large and small identical variations. So, definitely going to be looking through some of those 65s because some of these are in really good shape. Jeez. That one is in great shape. Alright. Well, that is absolutely amazing. This box has already been completely worth it. This is the best coin roll hunt I have done so far, by far. I'm going to continue doing coin roll hunting simply because of this box. But I still have, I think I'm only about 10 rolls down when I found those marked rolls. So I'm going to keep searching, and hopefully I can find some more octagon nickels, because you never know, right? But from all of these clear rolls that I've seen so far, I haven't searched a single one. They all seem to be pretty new. I don't see any really old ones. So that's unfortunate, but this was my lucky day, and let's keep searching. All right. Well, I think I might have just spotted something. I thought I'd let you guys in on this one. What do we have here? Looks like a 1961 octagon nickel. No, that's a little anticlimactic since we just found three rolls full of them. But, I mean, hey, why not take another one? This one's in pretty rough circulated shape, but finding these in the wild, can't complain. Oh, what's this? We got another one here. A 61. Nice. Well, not bad. Might as well finish looking through this roll before I tune you guys out. What's this? A 64. Alrighty. We're talking with this one. I don't think this is a coin dump, but we got Centennial War there. It's plated though. Not bad. Few octagons in that one, 65 there. Well, that's a nice old one. That was a clear roll too, so that's a good sign, honestly. All right, let's see what else we got in these other rolls. Well, I couldn't even spot this one in the clear roll, honestly, but let's see if you guys can tell. That's all I saw. And you know what that is right there. That's my buddy, George. What year is it? Focus. 1950. Not bad at all. Awesome. All right, this box has been amazing. A King George. Can't complain about that. All right, well, I'm going to keep looking through this roll, and then I'm going to keep it going and let you guys know if I find anything else, because, geez, this box has just been a treasure trove so far. All right, another one of those clear rolls, and maybe I was wrong. Maybe these clear rolls are actually not so bad, because... I spotted this. It's an Elizabeth head. 1957. Now that is nice. It's a little rough shape, a little matte, but it'll do. So, not bad. I can't see any other good ones in there. One shiny one, but I just think that's a newer coin. So, keep this going and see what else we can find. Getting to about a third to halfway through the box now, and I just made the best find yet, a 1949 George head. So, getting pretty close to where I want to be, to the World War II era. This was nice to see. It's pretty rough shape, but that's all right. I'll take it. So, second George head of the box. My worries have gone and turned to joy. Not bad at all. So, let's see if I can find one more of these. If not, that's all right. But, you know, let this be a lesson to you guys. I mean, I've heard things like Canadian coin roll hunting isn't as successful as American. And, you know, you can find lots of good stuff depending on what you're looking for. These nickels, for me, this is exactly what I'm looking for. So, not bad at all. Let's see if I can find another one. Well, of all the George heads and young Elizabeths that I found, who would have thought that this would have been one of the hardest? But luckily, I got it, the 1991. It's an extremely low mintage, and all the boxes I've looked through so far, I haven't been able to find a single one. So awesome that I was able to get this 91. So scratch the 91 off the list. Now I got to find the 97, and then my collection is pretty much complete from the 90s. Oh man, this was a hard one to find. This is looking like I won a box if you're lucky right here. But boy, am I glad that I actually found it, because I really needed it in my collection. So I got the 1997 and the 1991 both in this box. These are both really low mintage. If you give me 1 second, I'll tell you exactly what the mintage is for both of these. The mintage for the 1991 is 10 million. And the mintage is not as low for the 1997, but it is still pretty low. So I'm really glad to have this, so that way I can fill out my collection. And I did find another few Elizabeth head octagons so far, and I still have about a third of the box left to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to finish this up, and then at the very end I'll show you guys what else I find in the remainder. Other than that, this has been absolutely amazing, and I am so stoked. I cannot wait to, I'm going to try and get another box from this bank as soon as possible, because this was the best coin roll hunt I could possibly imagine. So, yep, I'll check back in with you guys once I'm done this box. All right, so it's time for the post-hunt weigh-in. This was a very good hunt. As good as any coin roll hunter could ever hope to do. I got three rolls here of 1960s, obviously a coin dump from somebody that was collecting. It would have been nice if these were 50s or a little older, but that is just awesome. I won't have to buy these to fill collections, and this is exactly what I was looking for. So that's amazing. And then these two stacks right here, these are young Elizabeth heads that I found in the loose rolls, and these are 1960s. That are the intermediate Elizabeth head. And then these are two Young George heads. King George the Sixth. And we have a 1949. And we have a 1950. So, if you're wondering, if you want to get into coin roll hunting, is this for you? Is it worth it? Are you going to find anything good? Hopefully this answers your question for you guys right now. This camera is probably going to be the small camera. So, basically, I'm just going to start tearing into the box. And let's see what we can get. I already looked for Enders, and I didn't see anything too crazy, but I did see a 77 Ender. So, if anybody knows anything about Canadian coin collecting, 77s come in two variations, and so that's a good sign. A lot of clear rolls here. Now, I do have some gloves, but I don't have them at the moment with me, so for now, just be going through these bare bones, but let's see. Ooh, a lot of new ones right now. Except for that. Boom, baby. Woo! 64. Young head already. First roll. Very good sign. So, I went to the older city I was talking about in my last video. What do we got here? First US of the box. 2014P. So, I'm really thinking it might be a better city to pick up boxes from because it's a lot older of a city. A lot more people live there. So, already a young head, not bad. 2009, kind of looked like a 2000P for a second. All right, there's roll number one, done already. So, I'll do five rolls for you guys to start. I usually do five rolls for every video, and then I usually tune you out and tune you back in when and if I find anything good, which I usually do. Right now, I am rocking a new placemat design, if any of you guys have noticed. This one is just a prototype of what's going to be a much bigger version, much better version, most likely. Sorry, got a lot of things going on here all at once. But I think that this will be a pretty good standard placemat for Canadian coin roll hunting. Man, these rolls. Why? Why, Lord, why? Alright. Let's see. First look. We got a couple older looking ones, but I'm not seeing any octagons in there. So, let's see. What do we have? Older one right there, 86, washed out. There we go, there's the 77, or there's a 77. Nice. So, it seems like coin roll hunting is starting to really pick up right now, not just on YouTube, but in general. When I was at the bank today, guy walked past me when I was turning in a box, asked me if I'm a coin roll hunter, so, you know, coins, man, they're making a comeback. Alright. First one of these of the box. This is a nice one. In nice condition, at least. But gun on the side. I already got a bunch of those. So. Alright. Nothing too crazy in that roll. Three keepers so far. Alright. Three paper rolls. Let's see. This is an interesting roll here. That one right there. Looks interesting. A little worn. What do we got? A US 2011, unfortunately. Nothing too special. This one is very chewed up. 2001, extremely chewed up. Don't want that. 1995. If this was a 96, we'd probably keep it. Because I only keep the really good ones at this point. So usually 65 and earlier, and US, and anything else that really intrigued me. 2000 P's I definitely keep. Here we have a 2000, not P, that looks like it might have went through a coin counter. It's got the circular marks on the edges. 1998, 2019, all right. Bup kiss for that roll. Bup kiss. All right. Roll number four. Are we going to get anything? Let's see. Don't see any octagon edges. '94. That's not bad. Another good year you can keep is '97 for Canadians. '97 was a low mintage year for just about every denomination. If you are not aware of that, 2009. Well, hopefully we didn't just hit a good one in the early rolls there, and we ain't gonna strike out late. Because I'm not seeing much else right now. You know, sometimes these clear rolls actually end up bearing the most in terms of good finds, even though it seems like in the U.S., the Loomis rolls and the bank sealed rolls usually seem to have the best success. 1980 there. But, oh, look at that. So, this might be some older stuff. Ooh, we might be onto something here. I think we are, because this whole roll looks to be a little bit older. I think this might be a dump. Not a good one, but 80, 81, 88. These are all a little bit older. 99. I really hope this box wasn't already hunted. 75. Oh, what's this? A 63. Nice. Our second young head, and there's another one up ahead I can see there. I don't know if you guys can see that. Oh yeah, you guys can see that in the pile. We are hitting some good ones here in this box, guys, and we're getting them on camera about time. 79. 81. So either this was an older roll sitting around for a while or some kind of collection dump. Oh, here we go. Another young head. 63. Very nice. So if you guys are watching this and you enjoy my videos or you enjoy Canadian coins or collecting Canadian coins, please hit the like button and subscribe for lots more cool Canadian coin videos and coin roll hunting in Canada videos. 84. Alright, let's see what this other young head is. Not an octagon edge. Another 63. So, nothing too crazy there, but we'll still take it. We'll gladly take that for our collection. 77. Looks to be some lows. As far as I know, the lows are the good ones that you want to keep, so. 86. 87, 69, it's a nice one, but doesn't quite make the cut. Another 77, So we are going to hold on to all of these 77s, even when they're gunked up. And an 87. All right, well, that was a good roll. I think we got three young heads in that roll. Not bad at all. You know what? I'm going to open one more roll for you guys alive. I'm going to break my rule. We're going to do the first six alive. And we'll start on the paper roll. Try our luck.
2,000 years later. Six.
If I can ever get this thing open. Probably should have checked for enders. Looks like there's a few old ones in here, but also some new ones. 87. Oh, there we go. It's not a young head, but it's a 65. Let's see. Let's throw this thing under the microscope quick, too. Nope. That is going to be a large beads, if you can't tell by that. So, that's unfortunate. So, I'll go through the rest of this very quickly. 2009, we'll still hold on to that 65 anyways. So, we are starting to hit some older stuff here. 79, 88. But there's some new stuff mixed in.
A few moments later.
All right, so going through about 10 of these rolls now, I'm noticing that a lot of these are nickel nickels, meaning they're actually made out of nickel, meaning they're before the year 1981. So that means that this must be some kind of collection dump, or this box or these rolls have been sitting around for a long time. One second, just let me dump these out really quick. Because I want to show you guys in the last roll, I found a lot of good stuff here. So look at this. We found some octagons. Now they're not in great shape, but alright, this 62 as well may have some doubling, and it looks like I can see some doubling maybe going on in the numbers there. 62, another 62. So, why don't we check these under the microscope really quick and see if we can see any doubling around 62. Nope, this one is definitely no doubling at all, so that is a shame. But this one, sorry, this one, no doubling on that I can see. But if you guys see any doubling, let me know. But as far as I can detect, these two are both plain, so that's unfortunate. But what isn't unfortunate is that we have gotten three octagon so far. So far so good. Gonna keep looking through this box, and hopefully we can find a King George. That'd be really nice, but if we can find a few more of these, that'll make it worth it. So keep looking. Tune you guys back in. So this has been a pretty strange box so far. I found a ton of US in this box, at least a roll's worth so far. And I went through the last couple clear rolls just to see what I could find, and then I found this. So this is super interesting, and when I looked, we got a 65 on one end, and we got a young head on the other. So this is a double ender, and then I do not know what is going on with that coin in there. I mean, it looks like somebody put it through the dryer, or I don't even want to know. Probably one of the dirtiest ones I've seen so far, so that's pretty interesting. So I got three rolls left. I thought I might as well just open the rest of these on camera for you guys. But pretty much this whole box has been just all nickel bullion. I mean, if you're hunting for bullion, this is basically your dream box, because about 80 to 90% of each roll, hopefully I can show you guys with these rolls, is nickel content. So I haven't found anything too crazy. You guys saw me pull that
You guys saw me pull those early 64s and 63 young heads. That's not too crazy. See, we got a 66 right there. 72. This one's not too much. The other ones were just absolutely insane, though. The amount of nickel bullion in this box. But nothing too impressive so far. I was really hoping I could at least maybe find a 2000P or something. I mean, I'm always hoping for George heads. That's usually what you're hunting for in these nickel boxes. See, we got an 87 right on the inside there. That's a newer one in 2012 on that end. But I've been checking the ends on a lot of these, and they've been getting double diadem enders on some of the clear rolls. So, diadem enders aren't too crazy, but it's an indication you might have something a little older. Yucky one right there. Very yucky. 84. 82. 87. Man, so many US's in this box. I don't know what is up with that. But, ooh. Now, I found two other US nickel variations. I'll show at the end, and maybe you guys can show me or tell me what they are exactly, because I'm not too sure what I'm looking for when it comes to US nickels. I'm very limited in my knowledge. An 80. So, now I did find... Oh, that's going to do it for that one. So one to go. The double under roll. So I also did find, I wanted to show you guys too, this here. The oldest find of the box so far has been a 1953 Jefferson. Would you look at that? Very nice. This is the oldest Jefferson I have right now, I'm pretty sure. So, that's totally awesome. But, at the same time, I almost rather would have gotten a George head, but this is still nice to have. It's in very rough shape. But, not bad. And then I found this, too, which is kind of weird. It seems to be an extremely pronounced strike. What's the mint mark on it? A D. So, it's not an S-proof or anything, but... Just a really nice strike on that one. Hopefully I can stuff that in an album. But, let's see what's in this last roll. Sorry to hold you guys up. So, we got the young Elizabeth head there. Let's see what year that is. It's not an octagon. So, the cutoff for the octagon date on nickels is 1962. 1963 is the first year. Not the first year, but the year that they reintroduced... the round rim back to the nickel. So, let's see what we got here. What is this one? A 65. Now, I've already found a big old pile of these, so that's nothing too crazy. And then, you guys can get a good idea with this roll, what I've been dealing with so far with this box. Makes it a bit tricky, because you gotta really search each one. 2001P, man. Oop, 77. I've found a whole bunch of those in this box. What I'm going to have to do one day is I'm going to have to take the old microscope and go through all the 77s, find the ones I want to keep, and pitch all the ones that I want to get rid of, because I do not need all the 90 or all the 77s, because there is the low, I believe, is the one that you want to hold on to, if you even want to hold on. See, this is what's weird, though, is you get all these old ones, and then you get a 2009 mixed in. Strange. 79, 81, 2009. There we go, another 77. That one looks to be high. The high variation. Sorry, I'm just going to pick it up a little bit here. 68 misses the cutoff date. Another 68.
Ugh. What is that one? 93. 2008. 79. We got a Jefferson. A dirty Jefferson. Wait a second. Wait a second. No way. No way. Oh my god, why won't it zoom? Oh my, where is the min mark on this thing? Where's the min mark? I don't see a min mark, so it must be plain. I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure this might be a silver war nickel. Oh my god. Oh my god. Yeah, I don't see a mint mark on this, but this is 1944. Look at the tarnish on that. I think this is a silver war nickel, guys. Oh my god. Oh my god, no way. I can't even, like, I can't tell. I don't know. As far as I thought there is supposed to be a mint mark above the little side of the Monticello there, but I'm going to have to look into that in between takes and let you guys know. But I'm pretty sure this is definitely a World War II nickel, but I don't know if this is silver or not. But regardless, this is now the oldest nickel, Jefferson nickel, I have. Oh my. That is amazing. Wow. Well, might as well finish going through this roll. Oh my god. Is this, what is this? 81. Oh my god. And here is the ender. The 64. I already found a whole whack of these too. Oh my guys. Oh my. That looks weird too, like the tarnishing on that is really strange. I don't understand. I thought this was just like a really dirty one. Usually when I see coins with an edge like that or nickels with an edge like that, they're just washed out Canadians. That is crazy. That is absolutely crazy, guys. We just found a World War II nickel in this box. Well, alright, I'm going to clean this up, and then we are going to do a quick wrap-up. So these are all the ones I decided to pick out of the box. I'm not going to actually be keeping all of them, and sorry, I'm still kind of in shock right now. But yeah, so basically I'm going to sort through a lot of these US, and I'm going to sort through most of these 77s, and pick out the keepers, because you don't want to keep all the 77s. There's only one variation that's actually worth keeping. So this pile right here, all 63s, this pile right here, all 64s, which we're going to have to check for the watermark. Then we got 77s, we got older Jefferson nickels, newer Jefferson nickels. We have 65s, which we are going to have to check for the large bead variation. Sorry. We have a few 1996s. Which they also have a variation. They have a near six and a far six. So one day maybe I'll show you that on the microscope, but probably not today. But I hold on to the 96s. And these were the other funky US ones I was talking about. I think I have one of these ones already, but these are pretty cool. So what does this one say? Ocean in view of the joy. Interesting. Maybe you guys can explain what that is, but it is a 2003P? 2005P. Nice. But it's nice. I like that one. And then I think I have one of these as well, but I think this is a commemorative Buffalo nickel. I mean, I would have loved to find a real Buffalo, but I mean, I won't complain finding a World War II American nickel in a box. Can't really complain about that. This is 2005 as well. Interesting. So I guess there's a set of these. Okay, and then this last one here. What's this?
I think probably 2000. Nope, sorry, 2004P. So I guess 2004 was the last year for this older school style of Jefferson nickel. Correct me if I am wrong. So this one has what looks like a ship on it. I'm not sure what ship that is. Probably says here at the bottom. Sorry, my shaky hands. Lewis and Clark. Okay. So that's a cool one too. Glad to have those. But the highlights of the box, obviously, right here. But the main highlight of the box, wow. I'm pretty sure this is silver too. I haven't looked into it yet, but I can just tell by the way that it looks. It looks a lot different than any nickel that I've found in a box before, so that is incredible. It's got some scratches on it, so I mean, very nice though. That is awesome. So, another successful hunt. I'm probably going to keep these nickel boxes coming because this was just absolutely beyond my expectations. I didn't expect anything like this, honestly. Here, if you guys want to, what I'll do quickly is I am going to just check a few of these 1964s for some watermarks while I do my sign out here. So, I really appreciate you guys watching along with this. This has been an awesome journey so far. I'm hoping one day I can be one of the big Canadian coin roll hunting guys. Like I was saying earlier, coin roll hunting and just coin collecting seems to be making a bit of a comeback. So, if you guys are into Canadian coin collecting, Canadian coin roll hunting, or just Canadian history and stuff like that, I'm also huge into World War II history, then make sure to give me a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button. I would really appreciate it. 62. So, all right. I'll just throw a few 64s under the microscope. See what we're dealing with here. So, as you guys, if you watched one of my earlier videos on detecting rarities in Canadian coins, well, there might be a die crack on that one that is... Huh, interesting. Okay, we'll do one more. Now that one is the most promising that I've seen so far for being the watermark. That one actually has some potential. So I'm gonna have to look at that again, but I just have so many 74s and 75s here. Or 65s and 64s to go through that I could not possibly look at them all in the microscope for you guys right now. So, we'll save that for maybe another detecting rarities video. But, other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm probably going to be doing a nickel box again very soon, so stay tuned for that. Okay. I was looking a little old. Let's see. No octagons. It's just a 2004. Oh, we got it. Our first Jefferson. A 1982. All gunked up. But we do keep all of the US that we find. An 86. So, good sign already. We're getting some older ones. Now, I'm going to be very selective with the nickels now. Because I have a lot of Canadian nickels. And I do not need too many. More of them. I mean, I got rolls of 64s, 76. 76 Jefferson. Nice. So, already finding some good variety in here, some good foreigns. Nice looking 2003. Now, these Canadian nickels, as you can see, are super shiny, which makes getting them on video a little tricky sometimes. Now, another one you really want to keep your eye out for is the 2000P. That's really low mint. So, two Jeffersons in that roll. Not a bad start. Let's see what's in clear roll.
number two.
Alright.
So, check for enders. Didn't really see anything. Few good old looking enders in there. A few worn ones right there. So, let's see what we can. I can see some U.S. tucked away in there already. All right, not bad. There's an oldie. 89. Don't need it, but another 89. We got an 89 Jefferson. So, I'm probably not going to keep all of them, especially if I get doubles of the U.S., but I'll have to check my collection. A 1990. Now, 97 is a low mintage year for all Canadian coin denominations, and 85. So, we're finding lots of old ones in here. That's good. That's a good sign so far. But, we need to see something a little bit older to make me happy. I mean, if I can get a few Elizabeth heads in this box, that'll be good. What's this? A 64. Oof, I hate seeing these. Now this is just a super common year for Jefferson Nichols, so nothing too special. Not going to even keep that because we have a bunch of 64s already. 1995. Alright, roll number two down. One Jefferson keeper in that one. Let's see what we can find in roll number three. Another clear roll with another tape job. Man, these rolls can be annoying. I tell you what. I don't even have my handy dandy letter opener here, so. You're gonna just have to bear with me. Now. I don't see any octagon edges jumping up at me. But, stupid tape, right there, we got an old one at the end, 1980, now, those are all going to be made of nickel, so if you're stacking nickel bullion, I mean, not bad to hold on to, but we are not stacking that here. There we have the commemorative. V nickel. Nothing too special. Let's see, there's another one right there. 1969. There we go, getting a little older. Now, 1972. Looks like a 75. Yep, 1975, so a lot of, oh, was that a 2000? Sorry, 2008. '82, '99, 2010. Oh, we got a 77 here. All right, now this looks like a low variation to me, but just to show you guys, I got some new tech recently, so why not highlight the tech that I got? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw this under my new microscope, and we're going to show you guys what variation of 1977 we have right here. So first, I just want to show you quickly what the new microscope I got like looks like. So I decided to get one that has a screen built in just so I can use it a little more quickly when I need to. So what I'll do is I'll show you the 7 on there. So you can see that the 7 on the right rests slightly below the 7 on the left. So there are two variations of nickels in 1977, the high and the low. This is the low 77. So, I just wanted to show you guys that quickly on the microscope. So, let's get back to the hunt.
So really, I just hold on to the 77s, and then I make a later judgment if I want to keep the highs or lows. But it's up to you which variations you guys want to hold on to. If you want to, I mean, they're not worth all that much. Ooh, it looks like that one's pretty old right there. But I don't see any octagon edges. I mean, this is only the fourth roll, so. Now about half of this box is clear rolls, and about half seems to be either customer wrapped or bank hand wrapped. All right, first I just want to take a look at what these ones are. It's a US one. Another 64. God, the amount of Jefferson 64s out there is just disgusting. We even get so many of these here in Canada. '86, all gunked up, alright. So, this one, not looking all that promising right now. Let's see. Maybe we can get lucky and get a 2007. Or a 2000P. Not a 2007. But boy, a 1947, that would be nice. Now, with all of the denominations, 1947 comes with a lot of different variations. It can come with a maple leaf, or it can come with a dot variation, depending on the denomination. Alright. And usually the dot is going to be the more valuable one, but if it has a maple leaf on it, and if it has a curved 7, it's going to be pretty valuable. If it has a maple leaf on it, it still might be pretty valuable. Thought that might be 2000. And 2012. Alright, roll number 4. Nothing there. So, last roll I'm going to open for you guys. Let's try one of the paper rolls and see how this goes. Let's see. Well, we got something that looks decent in there. What's this? Just an old worn out 89. All right. We got an 87. 2001. Now, to grab a 2000P in good condition, now that would also make this hunt worth it. If I can't get a King George or a Young Elizabeth, those 2000Ps can really make up for it. Oh, nice. We got ourselves a Centennial. Now these are common, I have a ton of them, but we do hold on to them. So, 16. All right. Well, that's going to do it for the first 5 live. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead, open up a few rolls, tune you guys in if I got anything really good. If I don't get anything amazing, then I'm just going to tune you guys in at the end of the video and show you guys the post wrap up. So we'll tune you guys back in. All right. So we're back in, and I have pulled out 2 octagon edges so far, a 61 and a 62, and 2 1963s, and I found one more 1977, and this one I believe is the high variation, so I'm going to show you guys that on the microscope. But before I do, I just want to show you, I found this 65, and look at the luster on this thing. It is in such good shape. I mean, geez. I mean, it has a lot of scratching to the surface, but it is still just as shiny, if not more than the other ones, so very nice. But what I'll do is I'll throw the other 77 under the microscope, and then I have something else really cool to show you guys. So I just wanted to show you really quick. You can see on the right that 7 rests slightly above the 7 on the left. So this one is the high variation. So to get two
different ones out of one box is just awesome, because usually I only get just highs or just lows, and I'll just get about two or three in each box that I get 77s, so really awesome to get a mix-up of these. Alright, so the reason I decided to bring you guys back in when I did is because I found something kind of interesting as an inner on this roll. So, hopefully that's a penny. Hopefully a Canadian penny, honestly. But let's see what we got here. I mean, if that can be a wheat penny, that'd be pretty sweet. But not quite sure. It could be something from Barbados, but it's looking like a penny to me. It looks like we got some other cool stuff in here. What's this right here? That's just a 2012. Alright, let's see what we got. What is this? Oh, it's an American Shield scent. And what's the year? 1983. Well, that's really unfortunate because we're going to lose 4 cents on that. And it's in really disgusting shape. But at least we got a penny. At least we got an American penny and not just something completely useless, which I guess that kind of is, but trying to look on the bright side here. Might as well go through the rest of the roll with you guys while we have it out, so see what we got. So still haven't really found anything too great, anything that I don't already have a bunch of, but to get those octagon sides, still not horrible. What we got here? Yep, nothing too special here. Alright, so I'm going to keep going along, and when I find anything good, I'll let you guys know again, or I'll tune you back in at the end. Alright, we just found something else really interesting that you wouldn't really typically tend to find in a Canadian box, but I'm sure you guys from the US know what this is right here. 2009. Now, I don't know about the mint mark. This looks like to be a P to me, but as far as I know from what I've seen, 2009 was an extremely low mintage year for US coins, so that would make this right here a pretty decent find. So, not bad. Mark that off as a plus, and we'll keep going with this. Alright, I was going to tune you guys in at the end of the box, but I still have 5 rolls to go, and I have found so much good stuff that I can't even save it all to the end. So first of all, I found one that I have been looking for a very long time. Now, the 1970 is super hard to find. It is just super low mint, and just really hard. Yeah, 5 million. So this is about as low mint as the 2000P, and I mean, it's not worth a whole heck of a lot. It's worth about $35 in mint state. So, I don't know. I would say this is worth about 25 cents to maybe a buck if you're lucky. But really hard to find in the wild. So, we found a 1970. We found a few more octagons. We got a 1960 octagon edge. We got a 1956 octagon edge, which looks to be cleaned there in the bottom letters over, or sorry, the bottom numbers on 56, but still pretty stoked to get some octagon edges. And then we also, got a 57 octagon edge. These are all Young Elizabeth heads. We haven't seen anything before on a Young Elizabeth yet. And then completely awesome. Look at this. 2000P. Look at that P on the back. That's a large P on the back. The other one that I have looks like to be a 2000 small P. Now, I don't even know if there's 2 variations of this one, but that's just awesome. This one's in really good shape, too. So, Detecting Daddy, if you watch up to this part, I gotta say I'm gonna be sending you a few of these ones that are harder to get. So, just wait, and you got a few good key date nickels coming your way. And then, also, I found this, Cayman Islands. I really like the obverse on this one, the portrait of Queen Elizabeth. Really interesting. But, so we got a cool foreign find too. And I found lots of cool. And yeah, I'm not too sure about this, but this 1964 Jefferson, it's got some weirdness going around. The rim seems to be thick on it, and I think that there might be some doubling going on in the letters, and this is just a really pronounced strike. I mean, if you compare this to a different strike, I mean, you can tell there's something going on with that strike. So I'm going to have to probably throw this under the microscope, and if you guys can let me know in the comments what you think about this. Now, as far as I know, there isn't any variations of the 64, but if you guys can let me know about that in the comments, it'd be greatly appreciated. But what I'm going to do is open up the last few rolls, and I'll let you know if I find anything. Alright, so this is the pile of keepers. On the very left top right here, this is 1963s, 1964s, 1977s. I found all of these US nickels, which is a very large amount of US nickels, to find in a Canadian box right here. Two 1997s, these are very low mintage, so awesome to get those. 1965. 1996, we have a 1991, which was about 10 million minted there. We have right here a 1970, very rare as well. I believe this is about 5 million minted. A 2000P, also under 5 million. 1967 Centennial. We have the foreign find of the box being this Cayman Islands 10. Whatever that might be. And then these are all the octagon sided edges we have. We have ranging from 1956 all the way to 1962. Or 1962 for the octagon edges, because that's when they stopped. And then we have one wheat penny, which is a 4 cent loss for us, not a wheat penny, one memorial penny in very rough shape. And, you know, I would throw it back, but I can't because it's a penny, so I'm pretty much forced to keep it. So, yeah, not too bad. So, this was a really good box. I probably don't need to keep all of these. I'm starting to accumulate a lot of 77s and a lot of US. So, I'm going to probably get some Whitman coin folders, fill those out with the Jeffersons. Well, it's nickel night here, and I've been having a lot of luck lately, so I decided to pick another box up. And this box here isn't from the usual branch that I go to. I decided to drive out of my city and to the adjacent city to mine because it's a much older city with a lot more history. So I thought I'd give it a try and see if I'm getting some old stuff there or if it's going to be uncirculated. To be honest, I already took a look inside the box and I can tell that it's circulated already. So that's a good sign. But I saw a few clear rolls. You guys know how I feel about those. But without further ado, let's start tearing into this thing and see what we can find inside. Alright, after inspecting some of the rolls in here, some of these look a little older. So, that's a good sign already. It could be good, could be bad. They're taped at the end, so that's interesting. But some of these rolls are in really rough shape, so let's see. Oh, there goes one. A 1996, though. So. Doesn't want to zoom. There we go. Now you can see. 1996. Let's see. What else we got here? 1996 is in really good condition too. So that's a good sign. Oh, here we go. First US. 2014P. Nice. Alright, so we've had a lot of luck lately with nickel boxes. And that's why I decided to pick this up. Because even though I am hunting for silver big time, you know, when you're having a hot streak, you might as well just keep going. And I've only had one box of uncirculated so far. Alright. Sorry guys, I'm working with a new setup here. I'm trying to make this a little bit better for you guys, some better lighting and stuff, because I've had some lighting issues in the past. Alright, well, I'm not seeing anything that jumps out too crazy besides the US. So, something else my coin roll mats are great for is dumping the coins into the box after every roll. Very convenient. So, checking for some inners. See one old one right there. It's a good sign. Let's see what we got inside. These rolls are annoying. Gotta see if we can neatly get that out. There we go. So, what do we got? Oh, 2000. 2000 plane. You're gonna see a lot of those. A lot of 2000 planes, but we found two 2000 P's so far. And those, oh, it looks like we got an old one next. What's this one? Oh, no. Just a washed out 2015. Commemorative V nickel. You see a lot of those. 2003. So, I got some pretty good new connections with my banks. And I'm hopefully going to be able to get a lot more boxes now. I'm going to be doing some quarter boxes soon. In the next coming weeks, hopefully, we can find some silver in those. 1988, well, there's something that's older, but not really what we're looking for. 2015, another commemorative V-nickel, 2001. Not seeing anything that jumps out in this roll. Nope, nothing there. So, roll number two. Skunked. Maybe we'll have some luck with lucky clear roll number three. Well, looks like we got one that's either old or washed out, but I don't see any octagons in there. Any sided edges. But let's take a quick look and see. Oh, this tape. Ooh, what's this? 85. I don't know if there's something special about this 85, but it just kind of honestly jumps out at me. I don't know if it's the color of it or the diadem on the back. It looks like something's up with it. Just gonna throw it to the side for now. I don't usually keep them, but that one just, you know, something really jumps out. Hmm. 85. With this lighting setup, it's pretty easy now for me to see if I got a good one or not. But pretty skunked on roll number three there. But I've only opened one non-clear roll and the rest of the box is all these that are taped. Oh, this one's not taped on the end. There's some writing in this box too. It says 43 written on the top of the box. Hopefully that's not meaning that they checked it. Alright, what do we got? See any octagon edges? Nope, not really. Alrighty. What's this? 2006. Alright. Just gonna quickly scan through. What do we got? 2001 P. That would have been a nice 2000 P. I don't have one in very good condition, but I would like to get one in somewhat uncirculated condition if I can. Nice. There we go. Another US. Alrighty. But, nothing too crazy yet in this box. I don't know. I don't know why these rolls are in such bad shape. Really been through the ringer. And they're pretty new coins in there too. Which is a shame, because if the rolls are just absolutely falling apart like that, well, there's a 77. And it looks like a low 77 to me. So we will keep that. I think I see another US. 2016. Not bad, we'll keep that. Now, I did find a 2009 recently in a box, which, if anybody knows, is a pretty good find for a Canadian box. 2001. What do we got here? Ooh, now that is a nice... Look at that. Look at the condition on that. That might be an album stuffer, because this is almost uncirculated right here. Let's see. Will it zoom on the shininess? Oh, there's a little bit of wear on the inside of that rim. A few scratches, but very good condition. Great luster. Might just hold on to that. But other than that, this roll, not looking too good. So, roll number four, you guys know how it goes. Usually I search five rolls for you guys. So, one more to go. And then I'm probably going to check you guys out and check you back in if I find anything good, which I'm really hoping. Oh, you know what? That was the fifth roll right there. Well, I lost count. Jeez. I guess I'll open one more since I said I would open one more. Why not? Let's open six rolls this time. But usually I would almost find a young Elizabeth head by now. Looks like we have a couple older edges there, but 87. Alright, what do we got here? You know this one. What is this? So shiny. 2017. Commemorative. But we don't want that. We want old stuff. And I'm not seeing much old here. 1989. Okay, well that's going to do it, guys. I'm going to start going through the rolls quickly on my own, and I'll tune you back in if I find anything. All right, I almost didn't catch this one before I just poured these all out, but I don't know if you guys can see. Right there, we got an octagon edge, so. Well, it's a young Elizabeth head. I was hoping for a George. That's too bad, but let's see what date it is. 1953. Nice. That's in really good shape, too. Jeez. Wow. Alrighty. Well, that's nice. At least we got a good octagon. That's a good sign. Might as well go through the rest of the roll really quick for you guys there. 1953. I might have to check the book, because there might be some variations for that one, but I don't think so. But that's still a good year. What's this? It's the commemorative. Thought it might be a 2000. 2001. Don't see anything else in this roll. All right, well, that is still awesome. Doesn't want to zoom. 1953. Very nice. All right, well, that's a good find. I'll tune you guys back in if I find anything else like that. All right, so it turns out we do have a variation. I'll show you guys in the book right after this what it looks like, but I'm just going to quickly look. So on the 1953, there is a shoulder fold variation. And what you would see, you can see there's a line
right in front of the chest there. This doesn't have it. Now there would be a line going across what I would call her collar there. So I'll show you in the book after what that looks like, but this is not the shoulder fold, unfortunately, from what I can see. And we're gonna look for the near far leaf variety. So this is the far leaf, so that's too bad. But in this condition, I mean, it's in very good detail. You can see everything. I don't see any doubling or anything going on, but this is still a $1 coin in this condition, I would say. So, not a bad find. And, yeah. All right, guys. So, I have went through the entire box here. These are the keepers. I'm probably not going to keep all of these U.S. ones. I'm going to probably fill my collections out, but I just wanted to show you guys this really quick. Look at that. 1957. 1957 D. So that is not bad. I'm pretty sure I don't have one of these yet, so that's a good find. Definitely gonna hold on to that. The rest of them are pretty common dates. Didn't find any 2009s this time, unfortunately. But I did find that very nice 1953. In great shape. I'd say this is probably better than VG, or at least VG, but probably better than that. And then I found this as well, which is one I definitely need in my collection. Look at that. 55. But someone got angry at Queen Elizabeth, unfortunately, on that one. And then the other two octagons of the box, 61, and another 61. And then in these piles, I have some 65s and 64s, so I'll do a quick time lapse and show you guys on the microscope if we have any of the variations, and then I'll quickly stuff my albums, and then we'll wrap this one up. Time, because what you're looking for on the 65 is you're looking for the very rearmost jewel on her crown. If you can see it in the very back there, it's hard to see, but it's a little dot sticking off the crown. You basically don't want that to be attached to the crown. It's gonna look kind of like it's floating, but when it's worn away like this one is, it kind of throws you off. But also it'll have large beads or denticles on the outside. But when it's got dirt and grime on it like this, it's really hard to tell. But I'm going to say this is probably a small beads as well. But it's always worth checking these. So, anyways, let's go to the wrap-up. All right, so unfortunately, I already had that 53 in my collection. But the good thing is, there it is right there. Look at the shape of that. So I'm going to be able to replace this. Let's see if I can show you the old one that I got. So, very glad to get a new one in there. So let's shove that in there right now. I'll just show you that one more time. This is the youngest nickel, or sorry, I guess the oldest nickel of the box. But so let's put it in its respective location. There you go, your new home. All right, and then also
this guy. Which is also, other than the obverse in good condition, the face of it's on in good condition, the reverse, I do not have a 55. There's the empty slot right there. So, I'm not too sure about the mintage on the 55. I can tell you in 1 second. 1955 was a relatively low mint, around 5 million minted for 55. So, not bad. Some good fillers. Now, what I'll do is I'll show you how my U.S. Jefferson nickel collections are coming along. I only have two of the Whitman books for Jefferson nickels right now, but these are my early dates. I have a lot of work to do on this one, but I have found some older ones. Unfortunately, that 1957, I already had that one, but this one was in much better shape, so I replaced the 1957 D-Mint. That was 1960 plain, and some of the other ones I have found, but really need to work on that. And then let's show you guys my other Jefferson collection. This one I have filled up quite a bit. I have. Now I'm missing the book in between basically these books. I need something from the 70s up to the 1996 around. So pick up one of those. But the real prize of this box, or of this book rather, that I found in my last box, nice 2000p. Now, the holes in this book are a little bit too small, so I really gotta jam these in there. Sorry if they look jammed. But, not too bad on the newer date Jefferson collection. We've been waiting a long time for this one, and the day is finally upon us. Quarter day. We got this $500 box of quarters. We're gonna search through it. We got our collection books. We're gonna see what we can fill in, see if we can find any silver. And honestly, there's a lot of different stuff we're looking for here. So this is going to be a really exciting one, guys. So what I'm going to do is I'm quickly going to show you all the different tools I'm going to be using to search through this box. And then we're going to get going and see what's inside. So let me show you what we're going to be using today. Got my handy dandy letter opener, as per usual. I have my Unisafe coin book. And in this book, I'm basically going to be looking for 1967 and above. So lots to fill in there. Then I picked this bad boy up, got the Whitman folder, absolutely blank. And what is this date? This is from 2001 until 2009. Look at that, all shiny. Very nice. So we're gonna be filling this thing in. What's this? Get this out of here. Nice. And then as my main reference today, I'm going to be using this, my Canadian Coin Roll Hunting Volume 4 Quarters. So here on the side, I have the bullion content for the different years. Most likely, we're going to be finding 68 to 2000. I have right here some of the main sets that you're going to be looking for the later years. And then on the back, these are the two most rare varieties, the most expensive ones. And then over here, we have the mint list with all of the prices. So that is going to be my reference guide. And just in case we need a little bit of extra assistance, we got the book here, the legit book, the Whitman's guide book. So if we need any extra assistance beyond my placemat, which most likely will not be needed because it is very thorough, then we will refer to this book for its great knowledge. So what I usually do is I usually open the first couple rolls up on camera for you guys. So I'll probably open the first 5 or 6 rolls, see if we get anything really interesting. And then after that, I'll tune you guys into anything really cool that I find. So first step, we gotta crack the seal here. Now, typically these rolls that I get from my banks aren't open on the ends. So they're not ideal for checking for enders. So I kind of just like to get right into it. So let's show you guys what we got here. One clear roll. So they opened this up at the bank for me, and I could tell that these were all hopefully circulated. This roll here looked like it was circulated when she opened it up at the bank, so that's a good sign. So move that back. We'll get this out. And let's start doing our first quarter hunt. So I am going to be edge hunting as well. See if I can zoom in. Show you guys what we're dealing with a little better here. Alright, so. Basically, just gonna keep in different variations of dates here. Looking for good old dates, hopefully pre-2000. I'm pretty sure pre-90 is when they were nickel. They stopped making them in 99% nickel in 1999. So we're going to be keeping any that are pre-1999. Any that are special whatsoever. Right here we have a centennial. Nice. Not bad. Not really looking for 2010 and on. 2006. 2009. Oh, here we go. We have our first Vancouver 2010. Nice. So, we are going to be getting a book for this, most likely. Not bad. All right. Another centennial. A P. The other one was a P as well. Sometimes it's good. Oh, what do we got this time? See, this is the fun thing about these quarters. There are so many variations here in Canada. It is endless, the amounts you can find. So this one here looks to be the 2013 Arctic Expedition. So, not a bad find. We'll put that in the keep pile for now. Not bad. So far, we are finding some decent stuff, but would like to see something a little older. 2008. 2009. Let's see something pre-2000. That would be nice. Another centennial. A 2019. That looks very nice and shiny. Very nice. 2010. So, not very many old ones in this roll. Another centennial. That's a popular one. They must have minted quite a few of those that year in 2002. 2016. So yes, this is my first quarter roll hunt. 2007. So if you guys have any idea, if you guys want to help me out and tell me what to keep an eye out for, that would be very helpful. Just let me know in the comments if there's any ones that you see me skipping through that might be good ones. Some of these are so shiny, it's hard to get a good view on them. Camera doesn't want to cooperate. There we go. 2011. Not very nice. Nothing good. Just a couple variations so far. Alright. On to the next roll. Let's see. No silver. No silver yet. Oh, we got another Vancouver 2010 Olympics this time for figure skating. Very nice. Oh, that looks like a 2008, actually. Not a 2010, but still nice. Throw it in the keep pile. So, if anyone out there coin roll hunts quarters in Canada, please let me know if you've had any success with finding silver. I found a silver in a dime box, but I didn't figure I was going to find much silver in a quarter box. I thought this was going to be more of a collection filling hunt, which I don't have a big problem with. 2012. Ooh, there's one that looks real nice here. What year is this? A very nice 2014. Now I'm probably going to end up chucking a lot of the ones from the keep pile back in to the box, because I only really want to fill the collection in with ones that I really want, I really need. So those would be the ones from sets. They would be proof ones, or they would be pre-1999, which so far we have not seen anything pre-2000. People have probably coin roll hunted these quarters quite thoroughly here in Canada. 2019. So, hopefully this will help all you guys out, letting you guys know what we are finding here in the boxes. Now, depending on the bank that you guys go to, you can have different levels of success. I mean, I've had quite a bit of success with one. Oh, here we go. First old one, our first full nickel quarter in 1993. Not bad. So that is a definite keeper, along with the ones from the sets. Oh, what do we have here? Oh, no, that's a 2000. 2000. Another 1994. There you go. Another nickel quarter. Ooh, don't want to lose that. And 2006. Alright, so we're starting to find some older ones. That's not bad. Two rolls down. So, I'll open three more rolls for you guys. Live here. Sorry, I had to stop the camera for 1 second a little while back there. You know, I got three cats and they can get a little crazy. Ooh, what is that? I'm gonna have something. I don't know if you guys see that, but nope. Just a gunked up, disgusting 2007. Well, that is a bummer, I tell you. That kind of looked like something to me. All right. So far we've only found two or three set coins. I really thought I was going to find more than that. Some of the set ones I'm really looking for are the Armistice Poppies. Very nice luster on this 2013. Maybe that'll be one for the collection. So the one with the poppy, that's a very nice one, a keeper. The Armistice quarters. Two thousand six, 2012, 13. Oh, I was looking for this one right there. Look at that. Now that's a nice one. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Glad to have that in my collection. 2009. Oh, I see something up there. Looks like another Olympic. And another Centennial. Ooh, we got another one of those ones. Very nice. Now they're not particularly rare, but I'm going to keep them and then probably keep whatever the best one is. Hopefully I can find one that's in decent shape. Maybe a little better than those, because they looked a little bit rough, honestly.
So, I'm still relatively new to this coin thing. I still have a lot to learn, but I'm learning pretty quickly. All right, what do we got here? Looks like the 2010 Vancouver Olympics skiing. Now that is nice. Oh yeah. I don't think I got that one yet. Nope, I got the hockey. I got the figure skating, but I did not get the skiing. So, very nice. Oh, what do we got here? Oh, we got the snowboarding. The Vancouver 2010 Olympics snowboarding quarter. Very nice. Oh, sorry, 2008. I guess this set ran for a 3 year, a few years. It says 2010, but on the back it says 2008. I'm gonna have to look into how that works, 'cause that's interesting. Twenty thirteen, what do we got here? Ooh, what's this? A year 2000 wisdom. Now that is nice. This is what we are looking for here. Some of these year 2000 and 1999 millennium coins can have some very rare reverse die variations that are extremely pricey. They can go for up to $10,000. So if we can find one of those, oh boy, I'm telling you. So, year 2000, wisdom quarter. Very nice. So far, this is going great, and I'm having a great time. This is exactly what I was hoping for, honestly. Ooh, what do we got here? Oh, that's just a disgusting 2016. Not very nice. Nasty, washed out 2016. All right, so three rolls down. Open two more of these rolls live for you guys. Probably should have grabbed a bowl or something to put these extra quarters in, but all right. We got anything on the edge here? What's this? No, that's just disgusting. Look at that. Ooh, get rid of that. Probably should be wearing gloves. Especially with sickness rampant like it is nowadays. Probably is a great way to get sick looking through coins. So, taking preventative sanitary measures is always recommended. But I do always make sure to wash regularly. Whenever taking a break up, we got another Vancouver Olympic here. What is this one? What is this one? This one, another snowboarding. Very nice. Sorry, my phone's just running out of space there. But I'll get you right back into this for these last two rolls. So, 2006. Ooh, we got something nice there. What's this? What is this? A 2002. P? Now this might be worth looking at actually. We might have to take a look at this after. This might be something. 2002 P. Commemorative. Very nice. Some of the Millennium sets that have P's on the back, they're known as mules, and they are extremely valuable. All right, we have a men's hockey from the 2002 Olympics. Now that is nice. Oh, 2009. So, very nice. I'm sorry if I'm getting these dates confused, guys. These quarters are so darn shiny, it's hard to see these dates on here for some of this. But 2009, I mean, it's hard to see that date on there. Looks like a 2002 to me, but I guess that's a 9. But regardless, very nice coin. So, from the looks of it, I do not think we are going to be getting any silver today, but we are definitely going to be filling in, hopefully, the 2010 Olympic set.
So that is not a bad thing at all. So I'm gonna try and move it along a little faster. 16. 16. Now, when I got these from the bank, oh, we got another Olympic. I did ask for as, ooh, this one is in nice shape too. 2008 skiing. Look at that. Very nice. Very, very nice. I asked them to get, when I went to the bank, I asked them to get as circulated as possible, and they laughed when I said that, because unless a customer brings in a bunch of rolls for a collection or something like that, there's not much you can do. So what do we got here? Looks like the Vancouver 2010 winter bobsledding quarter. Very nice. So I'm probably going to be filling in this Olympic collection just from this box hunt alone. So glad I'm not going to have to pay for that. Just going to have to pay for the cardboard to get it, to fit it in. 2014. So I'll open one more roll after this. Oh, looks like we got our first nice old one. What's this going to be? What year is this going to be? 1981. Nice. Very nice. So this is going to be 99% nickel. Our first Middle Elizabeth head. So there's going to be a few older ones in here. They're just going to be far and few between, I guess. So one more roll live, and then I'm just going to be bringing you guys in on the really cool stuff that I find. And there's probably going to be quite a few, so I won't bring you on every coin from every set, but as I find quite a few, I'll stock them up and I'll fill you in. So last roll. No silver at first glance. Oh, we got another Intermediate Elizabeth head. What's this one going to be? 1986. Now these are going to fill the books in very nicely. Oh, that shape on that one. Oh, why? I don't even know if I'm going to end up keeping this one, but I did want this. The Bravery Quarter 2006. But that condition is just terrible. Yeah. How does that happen? What do people do to their coins to let them get into that condition? Do they throw them in a fire? Do they put them through the dryer and the washer and then throw them in a creek for 20 years? Who knows? But every coin has a story. It's who knows how many people have held each and every one of these, which adds to my point earlier about how you should probably wear gloves when you do this. But as soon as, oh, what's this one? Just a centennial. Looked like something maybe, but no. Another Olympic. What is this one? Oop, this one looks like speed skating. Very nice. Lots of Olympics. Those must have been a very high vintage. This has got to be one of the best centennials I've found so far. Good condition. Not bad at all. So many 16s. That must have been one of the highest minted years as well. 2016, because I have found more of those than anything else so far. Another Young Elizabeth head, 1986. We found another one of those, but it's going to be 99% nickel. So, we're going to keep it. And 2006. All right, so that does it for the first five live hunt. So what we're going to do next is I'm just going to go through each roll and fill you guys in as I make a couple good finds, and then I'll keep this going. So I'll tune you guys out now, and then I'll tune you guys back in. So it took me a few minutes to get situated here, but I've separated all the good finds so far into piles. So this right here is my nickel pile. This right here is my rare variation pile. And I found one right here, a New Brunswick 1992. Now, I'm not sure, but the edge of that is looking a little interesting to me. So I'm going to have to throw this on the scale and see exactly what we're dealing with. But these right here, variations. These right here, Olympics. And then I just also wanted to fill you guys out on the progress of the book. So the book is coming along pretty nicely, I would say. From this one hunt, I'm about halfway full already. So let's hope we can fill the rest of this thing out during the rest of this hunt. I mean, I got a lot of rolls left to go. So I'll fill you in after I go through another good couple rolls, and let's see what we can get. Alrighty, so night has turned to day, or early morning, I should say. And I have finished searching through the entire box. And I have to say, I didn't find any silver, unfortunately. But I did find a lot of cool stuff. I found a lot of set fillers. So what I'm going to do, because I found so much different stuff, is one by one, I'm just going to take you through each of the different sets that I found pieces for. And then I'm going to show you what I found along in my book. So let me just take you through what I found really quickly. So what we have in these stacks is we have the year 2000 Millennium Commemorative Set. And I think I'm pretty sure I found about one of each of the different variations. So I found a couple for some of them, honestly. So that's awesome. I didn't find any of the rotated dies, which is a shame. And I didn't find any P's of the mule variations, which is also a big shame. I made sure to check every single one of them. But I did find a bunch of them, so I'm definitely going to make sure to get the cardboard cutouts and fill a few of those out. So an awesome addition to my collection. We got a decent sized stack of the 2002P Commemorative Canada Day quarters. A nice assortment of the 1999 Millennium Commemorative quarters. I didn't get the full set here, I only got five of them, but these ones are really hard to find. And if you can find the mule variations or the rotated dies, they're extremely valuable. They can be worth up to $30,000 for some of the mule rotated die variations. So to even be able to find these ones in the wild is very nice, so a very nice addition. So I did find quite a few more stacks of different variations, but this is going to be the last one I'm going to show you guys quickly here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a couple really nice pictures of some of the really nice ones I found in really great shape. But these right here are special because these are the 1992 Provincial Commemoratives. So right here we have the British Columbia, Manitoba. Now, I'm not 100% sure, but I think these could be made of silver also. Another British Columbia. Prince Edward Island. Can't quite tell what this one is. New Brunswick. The New Brunswick one's in very rough shape. But these all stood out quite a bit from the other ones when they were next to them. They don't really look that much different here, but I thought they did in the rolls at least. But anyways, very nice to find those. So to show you guys the progress I made quickly on my books, I was able to do extremely well with this one. Found just about everything. That 2001 is a very low mintage, so 2001 without the P mark. Couldn't find the 2005 Saskatchewan Centennial, unfortunately, but did find the 2005 Alberta one. And then I have a feeling these ones are going to be real hard to find too. So if you guys have any idea how hard these are to find or where the best place to find them are, let me know. But other than that, I pretty much filled this book out. So not bad, better than I was expecting, honestly. As for the Unisafe book, I made some pretty good progress in this too. So I was basically looking for later 70s and 80s, and I was able to fill the pages up pretty good. So these are all 99% nickel. So that's not bad. It's definitely going to need to grab another box so I can get some of the other dates. But, You know, not a bad start. Not bad at all.